I'm Daniel Foley from the Venn Life Training Center, and welcome to our daily community meditation, where today we're talking about how community simplifies. Community has the ability to simplify life and multiply what we're capable of, because we can only go so far on our own. So just the other day, I was thinking about just how busy and complicated life can get. We got all these things to do, responsibilities, all these just things that eat up our time, take up our time. It can feel like there's just never enough time to get it all done. I was just thinking about how do we simplify life? And God is just so good and gracious. He reminded me of a passage that I wrote in my book, Pockets of Prosperity. In Pockets of Prosperity, the goal is to create thriving communities, not just prosperity for yourself, but prosperity for the community of people around you, yourself included. And it was just a reminder for me. Life is meant to be a team game, a team sport. It's meant to be done in a community. God did not make us to function in isolation. Think about it. God didn't need us. He could have been doing fine just all on his own, but he wanted a community. He wanted people to surround him. Because community simplifies life. It multiplies what we're capable of. In a great community, there's diversity. There's people with differing gifts and differing functions, and they can take the pressure off one another, set each other free, so that we can step into who God called us to be. And it can multiply our abilities. Iron sharpens iron. There's just so many different ways the community, when done right, it can simplify, it can multiply, take us to new levels. And so we're going to take communion over this today, just asking God to help us to understand this and to get it right. But let's get started with our daily prayer, and then we'll get into our time of communion after that. Heavenly Father, I pray for everybody who's watching or listening, their families, their friends, everybody connected to them, and all of our church and governmental leaders. And I thank you for releasing us from darkness and transferring us into the light, into the kingdom of your dear Son. I thank you for your purpose and grace given to us in Christ Jesus before time ever began. And that Jesus was struck down, he was smitten and bruised and pierced and crushed and destroyed. Also that you could be on our side, that you could be fighting for us. And I keep asking that you, the Father of glory, would give us the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that we would know you more and more. That the eyes of our hearts would be enlightened to know the hope to which you've called us. And the riches of your glorious inheritance that is in us, and the immeasurable greatness of your power to us who believe. The same power that you exercised in Christ when you raised him from the dead, and you seated him at your right hand in heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And you put all things under his feet and made him to be the head of the body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. And Father, I ask you to bless us and to make your face shine upon us. Let us find grace and favor in your eyes. Expand our borders and our territory. Expand our capacity to receive everything you've given us in Christ and to let it flow through us so that we do good and are a blessing to people all over the world. Send us opportunities to do good and be a blessing today. And help us make the most of those opportunities. Keep your hand on us and help us do today what's right and best in your eyes. And do it with peace and joy and confidence in you. And we ask you to stretch out your hand to heal and do signs and wonders and keep us from evil and pain. Through the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So, Father, we're asking for your help. Help us to understand how running into community or rather than away from community can just take the pressure off of us, can simplify life, can multiply what we're capable of. It can set us free to new, greater and greater levels. And Father, help us to implement this, to walk in this. Teach us how to do community your way. And we think in the night Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and he said, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, you laid upon Jesus the punishment that we deserved. And by his stripes, we've been healed. He was crushed and destroyed by you, smitten by you. so that we could be right and holy and perfect in your sight, all through his one sacrifice. And you raised him up from the dead, and you seated him at your right hand in heavenly places. And you raised us up together with him and made us sit together with him. And we get this opportunity today to remember our union with you through the sacrifice of Jesus. And so, Father, I thank you for this bread and ask you to bless it in Jesus' name. Let's go ahead and take our bread. And after supper, Jesus took the cup. He said, "This is the cup of the new covenant. In my blood, poured out for the forgiveness of sins for many. And it's the forgiveness of sins that released us from darkness and transferred us into the light. We get to have this covenant relationship with you, Father. And so I thank you for this cup and ask you to bless it in Jesus' name. Let's go ahead and take our juice. All right. So recently we launched a new program called God's Plan for Accelerated Body Transformation. It's a very simple plan, one video to watch. Once you finish that video, you should know exactly what to do. But one of our goals is to build a community around that program where we help each other, we encourage one another, we share our results and our testimonies from it. And one of the things I've done, one of the ways the program got started for me is there's a breakfast that I've used pretty much the whole time that I've done that program. And it's a very good, very delicious breakfast, very easy to prepare, and that's French toast. I've eaten French toast almost every day of the transformation process. A couple eggs with some either regular bread or whole wheat bread. And I put a little bit of honey and whipped cream actually on mine. Have a little bit of a side of a fruit and a side of an egg to create a balanced breakfast. And I found there's been a couple different times where I've done some body transformations in my life, and French toast actually seems to be the breakfast that seems to work the best, at least for me. But you want to learn more about that program, a little more details about the nutrition, you can check out our new program there at the AbundantLifeTrainingCenter.com.